Hello, my name is Dr. Julie Earle. I am president of ProMedica Charles and Virginia Hickman Hospital. We are a rural hospital with 58 inpatient beds and a 24-bed emergency department. We're located in Lenawee County, which is approximately 750 square miles, located in southern Michigan, about 45 minutes north of the Ohio border. Our greatest population that we serve is our aging population of 65 and older. And we also have a population within our county that has a high SVI index and high Medicaid population. So probably many of the categories will not sound so unique, but I would say in rural communities, our challenges are much different than my urban counterparts. So talent acquisition. The providers of today are dual income, and finding that second job for that spouse is very challenging in rural environments. So we rely heavily also on foreign medical grads and foreign trained nurses. We try to charm them when they first come here so we can retain them. But again, in a rural community, we often have areas where we cannot provide the religious background or the food or the community support that different ethnicities are hoping to raise their families in. So often we'll see high turnover with some of our foreign medical grads. We also have lost a pipeline of talent, particularly for our technicians. We used to have a very robust community colleges that would feed our surgical techs, our pharmacy technicians, and we've seen a dramatic change in that. Housing is a struggle in many of our rural communities to help to support those jobs that have a lower wage or middle wage. Housing is in short supply, and that with rising costs of transportation and gas prices, it makes it really difficult for our younger talent to stay in the rural communities and often go towards our urban areas. Adoption of technology and using innovative healthcare approaches is also a barrier for us in rural communities. I mentioned we are 750 square miles, trying to adopt an acute care at home model that gets patients into the home faster and out of our inpatient beds is difficult when my nurses have to spend a lot of time or windshield time going from patient A to patient B. And it's not a very efficient model. I can do better when they're inside my four walls. Also, using advanced technology requires on internet support. Often bandwidth is a huge struggle within our rural communities, and that really limits how far we can stretch the use of technology to our patient population. So closure of rural hospitals impacts access and health equity. Zip codes should not predict the quality of care that a community receives. The great thing about medicine is it evolves. We have technology now that we didn't have years ago. But minutes matter. And when our community members are having to travel further for treatment, we're going to see a change in the outcomes and the quality of the care that we're able to deliver for common diagnoses such as stroke or heart attacks. We also need to look at the economic stability that hospitals bring to the communities that we serve. We're often one of the largest employers within our community and often give back to the community and other non-for-profit agencies, schools, local YMCAs. These closures will not just impact healthcare, but they're also going to impact the stability within the communities that we serve. So the increasing costs that we've seen with staffing, with supplies, with drugs, has really decreased our operating margin. Even though our costs of care have gone up, our charges have remained the same. We have not seen a reflection in payment from our state payers or our private payers to reflect the added financial burden to care for the patients that we're serving. We also are seeing a higher level of care required by the majority of our population. In rural communities, we have an aging population that often have multiple comorbid conditions, meaning they come in for one diagnosis, but they have underlying illnesses that may increase their length of stay or make their care more challenging or costly. With the increased cost towards delivering this care and the decrease in our operating margin, we're not able to invest in the infrastructure, capital needs, innovative technology. It also impacts the dollars that we can put back into the community, into non-for-profits, local schools, healthcare initiatives that think outside the box, food insecurities. So it has a global impact that goes beyond our four walls and into our communities. ProMedica programs such as the Medicare Dependent Hospital Program and the Low Volume Program are significant for the survival of many rural hospitals. We have received financial benefits because of our aging population as a result of the Medicare Dependent. And this has allowed us to keep programs open that we may not have been able to keep open otherwise due to decreasing operating margins, increasing supply costs. I'm fearful if these programs go away, it's going to significantly impact our service blind programs such as mental health, labor and delivery, where we don't see a profit margin that allows us to break even on our costs of care. But I also see it significantly impacting the dollars that we give back to other events within our community, such as food insecurities, free cost of care to our migrant workers. So these programs will have a huge impact, not just on our service lines, our community, but also in the number of beds that we're able to maintain. If we are closing beds, that means we're going to have longer length of stays in our emergency departments, and it's going to compromise the care we can deliver to the communities we serve. It is critical for these programs to continue in order for us to provide safe, high-quality care that's close to home, care that's equitable no matter what your zip code is. So I strongly urge Congress to push forward with both of these programs. Please support your rural hospitals and the communities that they serve.